Hey everyone, I'm a pragmatic kind of guy. I don't like spending loads of money on things that I just don't need. So when I started planning out my HomeLab NAS build originally, I was planning on buying a £60 B450 motherboard and a CPU like the Ryzen 3200G for a total cost of £120. So why did I end up spending almost three times as much for a DDR5 based system? Well, I think it's that if you're serious about building a fast NAS, AM4 or Intel LG 1200 probably isn't good enough anymore. I'm actually really happy that I paid £120 just for this ASRock B650 Pro RS motherboard, and I'll explain why in a minute, but I should add a quick disclaimer. First, if all you want from a NAS is a place to store lots of files that you won't readily access, and maybe you have no reason to go above gigabit networking speeds, then you won't actually need DDR5 and AM5 or LG 1700. Even many mechanical hard drives actually run fast enough that you can max out a gigabit connection. For example, a Seagate Iron Wolf drive can support up to 180 megabyte speeds, which would equate to 14,400 megabits per second speeds. My 4TB Nanji NAS actually runs old school hard drives, and this is fast enough to store all of our personal files and also act as a CCTV surveillance station. So if you're planning a simple HomeLab NAS build and you're not going to be streaming 4K or 6K video files, you probably could get by with a 10-year-old motherboard and CPU combo, and then stack your case full of 3.5-inch drives. However, in my case, I'm going to be using my new NAS build as a media base for this channel for the video content I produce. I'll be mounting the NAS's media drives as a network drive on my workstation PC, and also my laptop, and then I'll be doing all my video editing over the network. I discuss why I do this in another video, but essentially it boils down to me wanting all my media files in a single location, instead of having the extra complexity of having some of my video files on my PC, some on my laptop, and some on my Synology NAS, which hasn't been working out very well for me. This brings me on to why I think the DDR5 based platform like AM5 or LG 1700 is the best option here. When I say a fast HomeLab NAS, I mean one with super fast storage, in other words, M2 NVMe drives. Yes, you could get by with SATA SSDs, and their 500 plus megabyte speeds means that you could get close to 5 gigabit per second speeds out of them. That's pretty awesome. But many SATA SSDs actually cost the same as NVMe drives nowadays, so I kind of figure that NVMe drives are the way to go, considering they're often 6 to 10 times faster than SATA SSDs. So why DDR5? Well, many DDR4 based motherboards only have one or two M2 slots. Yes, you could buy a PCI Express to M2 card and get extra M2 drives in there. You're still sort of limited, especially due to PCI Express lane limitations with consumer CPUs. That's where the DDR5 platform is seriously impressive. There are loads of motherboards out there that have three M2 slots, for example, including my ASRock Pro RS board. That's why I bought it. And some motherboards even have four or five M2 slots. If you purchase 4TB drives, you could easily get 20TB of super fast storage, which seems like an epic position to be in compared to just a decade ago, for example. That's pretty cool, and since NVMe prices are very similar to SATA prices, if you want the fastest possible NAS speeds and maybe plan on having a 10 gigabit uplink, then going with a DDR5 build seems a no-brainer to me. I should say though that I kind of see the irony in me starting my video and being all like, look at me, I'm so pragmatic, and then immediately suggesting that everyone goes out and pays the DDR5 tax and does some really expensive build with NVMe drives. However, if you do need a super fast NAS or you think you might need one in the future, this seems to make sense to me, but please do let me know your thoughts either way down in the comments. This video is part of a new series that I'm working on to upgrade my media content workflow since I kept running out of disk space. You can click somewhere here to actually check out the other videos in this series, but I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.